Mari Extension Pack 5 R9 represents one of the largest R releases of the Extension Pack 5 series and is now supporting both Mari 4 and Mari 5. For Mari 5, Extension Pack has undergone quite a significant rewrite to support the latest required Qt and Python versions. As part of that rewrite, many optimizations were made, resulting in a lot of speed improvements across tools, nodes, and also just the general Mari startup time. While the rewrite to support Mari 5 would have been worthy of release in itself, 5 R9 also is the release containing the most new features and bug fixes since the initial version 5 release, with nearly 60 user reported bugs fixed and just as many new features added. So let's dive in and see what is new. In the Image Manager, we now have the option to open any image in another application via the Open With submenu. By default, you have the choice to open the image in the file browser or whatever application the operating system associates with the file format. However, you can add up to 10 applications to this list via the Configure Applications dialog, and on Windows, Extension Pack will see if you have either Photoshop or Krita installed and add it to the list of your applications by default. Here I have Photoshop in my list, so now I can quickly open an image, make changes to the image, and then using Extension Pack's Image Reload functionality, update the image in my Mari project. Speaking of reloading images, we now have the ability to reload image sequences we previously imported into a paint node. If I right mouse click on a paint node and choose File, Reload Paint, Extension Pack will reload the image sequence from its original path from disk. However, the Reload Paint option has some additional tricks up its sleeve, as it can also be used to reload a node's image attributes. Here I have a material populated with images created in Adobe Substance Designer. I have, since I imported those images into Mari, done some changes to them in Designer. While I could manually reload the images via the Image Manager, using the Reload Paint option instead, I can just select my material and auto-reload any images associated with that node. Reload Paint can also be used to force update the output of a so-called Bakepoint image port. Bakepoint image ports are useful to use the output of a node chain in an image attribute, while keeping a non-destructive connection to the original node chain. Here, I'm creating a custom shape using the Shape node. Then creating a Bakepoint node where I apply a blur filter. And finally, I pipe all of this into a Bakepoint image port on a splatter node. Instead of selecting the Bakepoint node and baking the result, I can now also just select the target node and execute Reload Paint, or press Ctrl and F5. And Extension Pack will auto-bake the Bakepoint and pull the result into the node. While in this last example, we used the pre-existing shape node, 5R9 introduces a series of new shapes to the library. We have, for example, the hexagon node, which, as the name suggests, creates a hexagon grid. But we also have shapes such as the polygon and polygon soft nodes, which further enhance Extension Pack's shape creation options. In one of the previous examples, we used a splatter node to randomly splatter a shape. Extension Pack comes with many different texture scatter and splatter nodes. However, they can be expensive to calculate and oftentimes are overkill when just wanting to have a somewhat non-repetitive pattern. In 5R9, a new lightweight hex tiling option has been added. While a regular tiled node just repeats a given texture over and over in a grid, the new tiled infinity node repeats different sample points of the given texture in a hex grid, making repetitions nearly invisible. The infinity tiling can also be directly activated on pre-existing nodes, such as the tiled extended node, the image node, and the axis projection node. Extension Pack's material presets have also been updated with the option, so you can easily hex tile an entire material. Since the last Extension Pack R release, users can easily change the environment light by dragging an XR or HDR image onto the canvas and choosing the environment light option to change the light. With this version of Extension Pack, this pop-up will now only appear if you are not already in the paint-through tool to prevent unnecessary clicking, and the pop-up can also be fully deactivated via the preferences. To make access to your HDRI library easier, Extension Pack 5R9 will automatically add images to an environment shelf. All the standard Mari environment maps will be auto-populated. However, also any folder you specify in the environment section of the path tab in your Mari preferences will be loaded in automatically. Here, for example, I just point to the asset folder of Adobe Substance and automatically get the same content I'm familiar with from the Substance applications, making it easy for me to work with the same environments no matter if I do work in Mari or in Substance. On Windows, Substance will be auto-detected on your machine and these paths will be added for you. Last but not least, a new lighting hotbox has been added on the F4 hotkey that allows you to change common light properties directly while being in your viewport. The Substance Baker Bridge coming with Extension Pack has been a huge success, and with this Extension Pack release, it now also works with Substance Designer instead of Substance Automation Toolkit, making it much more accessible even to users that do not have access to a Substance Enterprise plan. Inside the Substance Bridge, you will also now find the new Texture Transfer Baker, allowing you to transfer textures from your high-res mesh onto another mesh at the usual speed you're used to with the Substance Bakers. Going back to Mari itself, many improvements have been made to drag and drop functionality from shelf or image manager. For example, dragging an image into the node graph now auto-names the resulting node for you. Dragging an image that has a UDIM number in its file path and choosing to create an image node will now limit the visibility of that image to just that one UDIM, which of course you can change at any time via its tiling options. If we want to layer together multiple images quickly, we can use an enhancement to the Smart Merge action, which is mapped to the hotkey M by default in the node graph. While pressing M with two or three nodes selected will create a merge node for you, selecting more than three nodes will now intelligently layer the nodes together using Extension Pack's multi-mixer nodes. While previously I could always ingest images from my image manager into a material or node via the image manager ingest options, we can now create and ingest materials directly in one drag and drop action. Simply dragging multiple images into the layer stack or node graph will open the already familiar node type selector. In that node type selector, you also now have access to material templates from the shelf. The list will include any material you yourself added to the shelf, so you're not limited to using this with Extension Pack material templates, but you can add your own to the shelf and they will appear as options at the bottom of the list. So here in one action I create an Unreal material, confirm the mapping of the images to the different attributes, and my material is just ready to go. Materials from the shelf are now also available in the Swap Node or Swap Layer option. So with a material selected, I now have other materials from the shelf available in the list that I can swap to when pressing X. For regular nodes, so non-material nodes, this list now also includes custom procedurals at the bottom of the list, making the swap tool completely aware of any data you add yourself to the shelf. When working in the node graph or working next to someone working in the node graph, you're bound to hear a lot of clicking. Mari by default requires a double click to open a node's properties. In the Mari 5 version of Extension Pack 5R9, it is now possible to change that to a single click. You can find the option for that in the Mari Preferences node graph tab, and if active, your node graph experience will feel a lot smoother, I think. For your actual painting experience in Mari, some improvements have been added too. Mari allows you to project paint strokes either onto the front-facing parts of your model or have the paint shoot all the way through your object. This is controlled via the projection mode in the painting palette, and what mode is active is only visible via that palette or a tiny icon in the corner of your Mari application. Extension Pack 5R9 now allows you to add buttons for the projection mode and projection type to the interface, with the paint-through mode being clearly visible with its red color when active. You can customize the visibility and position of these buttons via the Mari preferences, for example to hide them or to add them to another toolbar. Here, for example, I add them to a custom projection toolbar, which I can place anywhere in my Mario UI. Another painting improvement is the ability to dynamically adjust your paint buffer bitdepth based on your active paint target, which can be found in the toolbar of the Paint Buffer Transform tool. While this option is not new, in the past it only worked based on your current channel selection. With 5R9, the option now works based on your current paint target and will switch your paint buffer bitdepth dynamically to the required bitdepth based on what node or layer is selected. Managing UDIM resolutions of paint nodes on large projects can be quite a daunting task. So to help with that, Extension Pack's resolution templates can now be used across all tools. You can now simply save a template of a UDIM resolution layout and then reapply this template to any channel, paint node, or even bake points. When working with multiple objects in your Mario project, it is now possible to sync the channel selection across all objects in your scene. Here I have my diffuse channel selected, and by pressing the sync channel option, all other objects will get the diffuse channel made current too. This is in addition to the previously introduced sync shader option, which does the same, but for your currently active shader syncing it across objects. The syncing of channels is now also automatically applied to the screenshot all channels tool, which has received an overhaul. So each screenshot will now represent a channel across objects in your scene. That concludes this overview. There's more to discover in this release, so make sure to check out the full release overview page. And happy painting with Mario Extension Pack 5R9.